George Lucas was born in the year 1944 in Modesto, California. At a year old, he and his parents attended Disneyland the first week it was opened. George fell in love with the park ever since and desired to visit often. His interest in animation, television programs, comics, and science fiction were a priority until he later developed a passion for car racing. During his high school years, George was usually found racing at fairgrounds and hanging out at garages. His love for auto racing was inextinguishable, so his parents never bothered themselves trying to dissuade him from it. In 1962, a few days before his high school graduation, George was driving when another driver collided with him, flipping his car several times before it finally crashed into a tree. George's lungs were severely bruised and he was in hemorrhage until an emergency medical treatment was administered. After recovering from the accident, he abandoned his interest in racing and pursued other passions. George's father operated a stationery store and wanted his son to work for him, but George wasn't interested. Later on, he was admitted at Modesto Junior College, where he studied literature, sociology, and anthropology. He developed an immense love for capturing events with a camera, which led him into the filming industry. George attended the School of Cinematic Arts at the University of Southern California, where he graduated with a Bachelor's of Fine Arts in Film. After his graduation, George was ready to venture into filmmaking. He came up with a unique story that was produced into a full-length movie. However, this production failed completely and resulted in a loss of money. George wasn't discouraged or deterred by this, even though many of his acquaintances advised him not to waste money and time on something that wouldn't yield profit. He came up with another project, American Graffiti, a movie he directed all by himself. This movie became a success and led to a breakthrough that announced George to Hollywood. However, this courageous man wanted something bigger. He proposed another movie project to two large film manufacturing companies in America, but was reportedly turned by both companies, and the movie was rejected because of its bizarre story. George kept showing his scripts to other studios, who declined until 20th Century Fox accepted the story and produced it. The movie was titled Star Wars, and it became one of the highest-grossing films of all time. This made George incredibly famous within the movie industry. To this day, he's one of the wealthiest filmmakers worldwide, with an estimated net worth of $5 billion. So many people would have accomplished their goals and become great if only they had rebuffed the discouragements they got from people. Discouragement is the persuasion not to take a particular decision that will lead to happiness due to the difficult circumstances surrounding that decision. Guy finally said, "Discouragement is a negative emotion with more than one trick up its dark sleeve. It tricks you into emotionally or mentally dwelling in the very place you want to leave. Nobody wants to dwell on challenges. However, many people are still entrapped in their problems because they've allowed themselves to be discouraged by taking the necessary steps to becoming free from such problems. When you succumb to discouragement, you will always remain in a particular spot without progressing." Joel Austin said, "Stone of judgment, discouragement, or doubt may be thrown at you. You can't stop them, but you can make a choice to keep your walls up and not let them affect you. Whenever you're striving to achieve a goal, certain people will definitely discourage or judge you. You can't seal their mouth from speaking, but you can seal your ears from listening to them." Katrin Pulsifier said, "Do not be discouraged if your plans do not succeed the first time. No one learns to work by taking one step. No one has ever achieved success after a single attempt. It took a series of repeated efforts before success was actualized." Just because you failed at something doesn't mean you can't try again and succeed at it. People tend to discourage you from doing a particular thing because it's not working, but it's your sole duty to simply ignore them and keep trying until it works out. As you wake up this morning, make a promise to yourself never to look back. Make a promise to yourself never to be discouraged by life's obstacles. Make a promise to yourself never to listen to those who want you to take the easy way out.